Hey coders, welcome to our first video on exploring UIKit. This is Apple's foundational framework for building iOS apps. In this video, we're going to set up a simple UIKit app, work with some buttons and labels. If you're new to UIKit, this is where we're going to be starting from scratch, so it's perfect to begin here. So let's dive on in. We're actually going to open up our Xcode. We're going to create a new project this time. Once you've selected that option here, you can select the iOS tab on this kind of like range here, and you'll want to select the app under the application. This is where we're going to be kind of setting up our template, so a lot of the kind of groundwork will be done for us. You can press the next button. You can name your product whatever you'd like. Maybe if you want to do UIKit demo, feel free to do so. You can set your team, organization identifier, and you'll want to put your interface to be Storyboard. This is where we can kind of visually plan out our phones on the phone screens. You'll see what I'm talking about once we kind of hop into things. Make sure that your testing and your storage is set to none. You don't need to host it in CloudKit. Your language should be on Swift, but your interface should be Storyboard. So take a second to make sure yours looks pretty much the same as mine, especially these four options down here. If you're using an older version of Xcode, same things like the tests, they might be in little checkboxes. You can just uncheck those and hit next. This is where you can save your program. I'm gonna save mine in my Xcode projects here on my Mac. And you don't need to have the source control create Git repository on my Mac selected. We're just going to go ahead and hit create. Might take a couple seconds, but we're going to be greeted with a new environment here. All right, before we kind of hop in, let's take a really quick look around Xcode. So on the left side of our screen here, we have the navigator area. These might be kind of, collapsed for you. You'll just want to kind of click on this app symbol that has the same name as your program. You want to open it up with these little tabs here. You can open up this folder, and this allows you to see all of your project files. In the middle here, so if we click on our main, this is kind of our editor window. This is where we'll be doing a lot of our code and working with our design elements. On the right side, this is typically where we have our utilities. So we have the inspector panel. This is the attributes inspector, and it kind of allows us to, make changes to any elements we have selected. For example, if we click on the background of this phone screen here, right now it's on the system background color, but we can choose any color that we'd ever like. We can select it to be orange, and we can see that it reflects here. So any of the attributes we can kind of change on this right panel here, or we can change them with code, up to you. On the bottom area, we do have some debug. So it's that console. So if you're familiar with Swift Playgrounds, you've definitely used the debug area before. This is going to print any of those statements, any errors that we encounter. They're going to end up in that debug area at the bottom here. Okay, cool. So we might as well hop on in and start building right away. It's that simple. So this is kind of our canvas, and it does represent a phone screen here. But what we can do is we can access the object library. For me, that it's this plus sign at the top here. If we click on it, it says show library. And we can see that we kind of have this whole library of items. It also provides a brief description when you are selecting on it. So our label is going to be that most basic way of displaying kind of static text to the user. You're not going to be able to really like interact with it like directly with the user. Maybe if we press a button, we can update it. But this is kind of your way of displaying text to the user. So anytime you want to add an element, you can just select and drag and drop. You will notice that we do kind of have these snap grids. We use that kind of alignment. So if you want to put it dead in the middle, we absolutely could. If you want to change the text, you can double click on the label and we can change it to be like, hello, UIKit. And we can hit return to update it. We can also drag it and drop and kind of move it once we've already added it. And you'll also notice in our attributes inspector on the right, we have so many options on how we want to format this label here. We can of course change these all with code, but this gives you a really easy way to change and customize your program to your liking. I'm also just going to make our label area a little bit bigger here. So cool, that's how we can add label. All right, now let's add a button to our view, and we can do the exact same thing. Let's go to our object library, and let's grab a button. All four of these buttons, they kind of, you know, act the exact same way. They just look a little bit different. I like a filled button. I think it kind of pops off the screen a little bit more. And just with the label, we can double click on it. We can change what it says. You can also change it on the attributes inspector. So we can see here when I change it to press me, we can change it there as well. I'm just gonna change it back to say press me. I can even change the background, the color, the font style, totally up to you. If you really want to play around with the, you know, kind of look and feel of your app, which I really suggest doing, you know, make it to your app's brand or your personal brand, you can do most of that through the attribute inspector here, which is really cool. And what we're going to have happen is we're going to press the button and we want an action to, you know, occur. So how can we connect these elements that we've created to our code? Well, we actually need to use the assistant viewer. So let's take a look at how we can do that. So to access the assistant viewer, you can either select these lines here at the top where it says adjust editor options. You can go to the top of your screen, press editor and open up assistant. It's totally up to you, but we want the assistant to kind of pop out on the side of our screen here. And this is how we can be working and connecting our phone screen with our code. So what we need to do now is we need to control drag our label from the storyboard here into our code. I always like to make a little bit of extra space here just so it's easier. But you'll see once we hold control and then left click and drag, we kind of have this new kind of blue bar up here. We can actually drag and drop. And this is where we can add our connection outlet. We can also give it a name. So I'm going to call mine hello label. And we can hit connect. And we'll see that we now in our code have a new variable that says hello label, and it is a UI label. You can also hover over the line of code here, and it will kind of highlight where that is on the screen, which is pretty cool. So we can do the exact same thing for our button, but instead of putting it at the top here, we're actually going to put it under the override function viewDidLoad. So what I like to do is I like to kind of have this viewDidLoad kind of serve as a middle ground for myself. So any outlets, so any variables, you know, anything that I'm kind of declaring are going to go at the top, so above the viewDidLoad, and any functions, so anything that's kind of action-y, is going to take place after the viewDidLoad. So it already knows I'm dragging the button on. It says, okay, connection type is going to be an action. We can give it a name as well. So let's say button pressed. Under the type, instead of any, I am going to select it to be a UI button. The event, I'm going to leave it on touch up inside. So when the user presses on the button, I want something to happen. You're going to get so used to, especially working on UIKit, so used to adding elements and then adding them to your code. Just remember control, drag and drop, give it an appropriate name, any variables, constants, things like that. You're going to want to put at the top here, any actions or functions under the viewDidLoad. That's just my general rule of thumb. All right, now let's write some code in order to update our label when the button is pressed. So we can go inside our function here. So I'm going to make some spaces inside the brace. And all we'll have to do is update the text value of our label. So if we go ahead and reference our hello label, and we've already declared it as a variable up here, we can actually press the period and we can see a whole bunch of properties. Because we want to update what the label says, we're going to go ahead and select the text property. So you can either type it out or just press return. And let's have this equal a new string, and we'll say button pressed. So now what should happen is when the button is pressed, this label should change from hello UIKit to say button pressed. So let's go ahead and see how we can have these, you know, be demoed for us in person by using the simulator, which is pretty cool. So you can either press command R to run or press this kind of play button in the top left. And from there, we're going to be able to launch the simulator. You can also change what phone or device you're simulating on. If you see the top of my screen here, where it says iPhone 16 Pro, you can go ahead and see all the different iOS simulators you have. You can even manage the run destinations or even use your own phone, iPad, etc. for testing on. The simulator did kind of open in the background here, so I'm just going to move it over slightly. The first time you do run any program, it might take a little bit longer to get your code to run. Sometimes it's my first, kind of open of the day on my Mac. I'll go up and, make myself a coffee in the morning or something. But we can see our program is already good to go. And we have our press me button, hello UIKit, looks exactly like our storyboard. And if you press on the button, her text updates to say button pressed. Pretty cool. All right, so that's it for the UIKit intro. This is something where we're just, going over setting up the Xcode project, exploring the very, very basics of storyboards, and make the most basic app that we can with a button and a label. If you enjoyed this video, please let me know. I'm going to be working on, creating a whole series of this for UIKit, as well as for Swift UI, and I also have my Swift Fundamentals videos if you want to learn about the basics of Swift and the Swift in 60s, those little bite-sized Swift videos. But until next time, dream big, code bigger, have a wonderful day, and explore UIKit. It can be really fun.